So before we kind of dive a little bit deeper in like techniques and stuff and resources available, there's one thing, and if anyone's seen Talladega Nights, what do I do with my hands? Specifically, like just talking about the left hand, it's something that I know going through beginning conducting classes or conducting university band, it's still something that I'm developing and figuring out, like, what do I do with this hand that doesn't have a baton? What's kind of advice that you have, Dr. Wimmer, for developing like fluidity or independence in this weird appendage you have?
Yeah, so as a percussionist, independence and exercises dealing with paramutations are absolutely key to be able to play the drum set with all four limbs going at the same time, or to be able to play a multi percussion piece where you're holding two mallets in one hand, you're holding one mallet across your body with another hand, and then you're doing something different with your foot. And so my approach to that with beginning conducting, and so I'm basically teaching where the floor, where the walls, and where the ceiling is, so that you know where the rules are, you know where the boundaries are. How I approach that is, your right hand will conduct time, and then your left hand will show something musical. So that's kind of how I break it down, so that we can isolate as a beginner. Okay, so you're doing a good job of showing your music with the left hand, but you need to work on your right hand. So let's isolate drop the left hand, work on the right hand. Then also vice versa too. There are students that are, that are in the opposite scenario. So one exercise that I actually recommend doing is conducting a 4-4 pattern, just at a smaller dynamic level. We all can teach. We all can conduct big. We all can be the drum major. That's not going to be a problem. Where I think we need to focus more as conductors, especially beginning conductors, is conducting in a smaller space. And so I like using, I want you to conduct inside a postage stamp. I want you to conduct inside a note card. I want you to conduct inside my phone. In university band, I'll be in the back of the room and I'll hold up my phone and I'll point. Okay, so I want you to conduct one, two, three, four inside my phone to be able to reduce that pattern. So conduct a 4-4 pattern with your right hand, and then with your left hand on beat one, you're just going to give a cue. One, two, three, four, cue. So you bring your arm up and down, cue. Now we're going to move to beat two. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Beat three, beat four, et cetera, et cetera. Change the pattern. 3-4, 2-4, 5-4. So at least you're experiencing the timing of when you need to engage and disengage your left hand. Once you're able to engage and disengage in time in an efficient manner, then you can start talking about, use of lobbing gestures, or use of, more or use of, Elizabeth Green style gestures to be able to get to that gesture and then go back away from it too. So you can't look musical if you can't move in time and if you can't coordinate that all within yourself. So that's one thing that I teach my undergraduates, and I think Eric, you can attest to this too, because you went through my conducting palindrome. I'm all about creating exercises that put your body. It's just like a drill. Like I mentioned, doing cone drills as an athlete, you do those drills to replicate what could happen in a game, so your body's prepared in the game. The exact same thing as a conductor. So if you are able to experience moving through space in time at a particular point in time, isolated, that just means when you're in front of an ensemble and you're responding, you're going to be able to be moved in that fashion already, then you're going to be more likely to move in time, at any given point in time. So that's one of the things that I do to kind of help just answer the question, what do I do with my left hand? Well, you have to plan and know what to do, but before you know what to do, you actually have to have physically done that or moved in that capacity so that you can do that. A lot of people get on the podium and they go, I was planning on doing this. Well, one of my questions is, well, did you practice doing that? Did you actually break down? So if I want to give a cue on beat three, what has to happen with my left hand on beat two? I need to prepare that. Then on beat one, I need to be thinking, must prepare now. Then once beat three happens, what do I do to retreat away back from that, in a musical and in a time related area?